Hello learners, welcome to NIOS. Today we will take up a fresh topic of your physical education and yoga syllabus. In this video, we will study part 2 of lesson number 9. The title of the lesson is Introduction to Health. So let us begin with the second part of the lesson. Learners, the key principles of health are balanced and balanced diet, regular exercise, adequate rest, no use of drugs and positive thinking. Apart from this, few more principles are emerged, which are: the first principle is to get fresh air. The air we breathe plays an important role in proper functioning of our body. Continuing exposure to toxic or polluted air can decay the health and functioning of the cells and organs of our body. This can lead to increase of exposure to infection and various forms of airborne disease. Second principle is to drink adequate amount of pure water. Water is critical for our life and functioning of cells, tissues and organs in our body. Water carries elements of life and has the ability to transmit and maintain them. Our body is made up of about 75% of water. Every single cell in our body is made up of water. Nerve functions, blood circulation, digestion, elimination of waste, etc. depend on water for their normal and effective functioning. The next principle is to eat nutritious foods. Our health is literally depend on what we eat. The food we eat plays a significant role in the functioning of our body, health and well-being. A healthy diet consists of balanced amount of carbohydrates, fats, fibers, minerals, proteins, vitamins and water. We should try to have these nutrients in our food. The other principle is to avoid uses of tobacco products and alcohol. Use of drugs, smoking and alcohol is harmful for our health. Avoid bad habits of drugs use, smoking and use of alcohol. Drugs uses cause many disease and hamper our health. It usually shorten our life expectancy. For better health and quality of life, always say no to uses of drugs, smoking and alcohol. The next principle is to get proper sleep and relaxation. Proper sleep and relaxation plays a crucial role in the individual's physical as well as mental health and functioning. Improper sleep can affect immune system, which can lead to various forms of health problems. Some experts believe that lack of sleep can make the body become resistant to insulin, a hormone which helps carry glucose from bloodstream to cells. Other problems resulting from lack of sleep includes lack of mental clarity, memory problems, mood disposition and higher stress level. Go for regular physical activity or exercise is the other principle. Physical activity exercise has a host of many health benefits. Do whatever sports or physical activity you like on regular basis. Regular exercise keeps the body strong and healthy. Regular exercise can make our body system stronger and more efficient. Some benefits include reduce risk of having diabetes, reduce risk of blood pressure, helps in weight management, develop strong and healthy bones, muscles and joints, improve blood flow throughout the body, improve the body's capacity to use calories and reduce both mental and physical stress. The list of benefits of exercising is very big, so start exercising on a regular basis for your better health. The other principle could be meditate and reflect. Taking time out from your busy schedule to meditate and reflect can act as good medicine. Meditation and reflection is now recognized as having many benefits for health and well-being. It has been implemented in the management of some forms of illness, management of stress, and even in the accelerated learning programs. For inner happiness, it is important to meditate and reflect. Think positive and being in control is the next principle. Positive thinking generates positive vibes in our body. Always try to keep your mind and emotions in a conscious control. Positive thoughts and emotions lead to positive feelings and have a positive effect on our body. Positive thinking always keeps you in a happy state of mind that will facilitate good health and well-being. If we truly adhere and live by these principles of health, it will contribute to us a long, healthy and happy life. It will also help us to avoid lots of disease, undue stress and many forms of unhappiness. Learners, you have learned about different dimensions of health, and it reveals that lots of factors are involved in the determination of our health. Individual characteristics, behavior and other factors affects on health and community's health as well. So now we are going to study few more factors which could affect our health. The first factor which affect health is personal essence. Personal essence means descriptive characteristics and concept of our life. It is related with our belief system, expectations from the life as well as purpose of our life. You can say personal essence is a lens by which we can perceive our life. If our personal essence is not in harmony with a desire, that will have an adverse effect on our health. The second factor which affects health is heredity. From the time of conception, our health is determined by our genes. The genes we receive from our parents cannot be altered. Few diseases such as diabetes and mental retardation passes from one generation to other is having genetic origin. More or less, our health is depending on our genetic makeup. The third factor which could affect our health is environment. Environment, whether it is internal or external, plays a dominant role in determination of our health. Internal environment relates with the functioning of our internal organs and systems, whereas external environments relate with our surroundings. We can expose to any disease if any one of our organ or system starts malfunctioning. Same will happen if our external environment like air or water quality are not good in that quality. The other factor is lifestyle. Lifestyle is one of the most determined factor which influences our health. Lifestyle means the way we live. A culture plays a significant role in deciding our lifestyle, like on our behavior and habits. There is an influence of our culture. Good lifestyle such as good food habits, right sleep pattern, habit of exercising will have a positive effect on our health. Next factor is social. It is said man is a social animal, and for survival we have to interact with fellow beings. Socialization means establishing a cordial and positive relationship with other individuals of the society. If we have cordial and positive relationship with the other fellow beings, that will contribute to better health. Further, the next factor is gender. A gender is also one of the influential factor for determining our health. Like women are prone to calcium deficiency disease due to menstrual period, whereas men suffers with different kind of diseases. Next factor is gestational and developmental factors. This factor is related with the young children. It relates to genetic makeup, intrauterine influences, any birth trauma, and the effect of vaccination. All of will influence our health. Progression of disease is one of the other factor. When we are not able to handle the severity of or duration of health destructive factors, that is known as progression of disease. If we are not getting proper treatment in due time, that would result in progression of disease or illness and will make conditions worse to handle. External factors are also there, which could be anything. It could be accident, sudden trauma or injury, exposure to electromagnetic frequencies by the use of laptops, mobile phones, remote keys, wireless networks, working conditions and hours, etc. It also relates with the use of chemicals in our personal care items. The influence of external factors on our health is very huge, and it is required to address for better and healthy life. Last but not least, socio-economic conditions such as our income, educational level, nutritional status, employment and health services are also one of the factors on which our health is depends. Learners, with this, we have reached the end of lesson number 9, part 2. In this video, we have learned the principles of health and the factors on which, you can say, the factors which influences our health. We will continue with the present topic in the third and last part of this lesson. I hope you liked watching this video. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.